Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is The World Away, and we now got stages 15 to 18 of the Fanhome release of Build the Knight 2000 from Knight Rider. Now if you remember in the last stage, we had already finished the chassis and we had done one of the other brake discs as well. Let me just show you that. So that was the chassis here. And then obviously we had this wheel arch, which we hadn't put on yet. I'll put that to one side. And we had also created one of the brake discs. And as you can see, I've already put one of Mike Lane's mods on there just for the brake disc, so I can make the next tire that we do look like that. And I believe that's how we're going to be starting this pack. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I have put the link in the video description. If you follow that link, you can get this all the way from pack one. Now, Fanhome at the moment, they've got a plethora of things there that you can actually get as well. You've got the R2-D2, you've got the Iron Man, you've got the Fast and the Furious Dodge Charger, you've got the Star Wars bus collection, you've also got the Star Wars encyclopedia collection. There's loads over there. Go and check that out. But we're going to jump straight into stage 15. So without further ado, let's get cracking. So as you can see, lots of tiny items in stage 15 here. I'm just going to push them all to one side because what we're going to need is the wheel arch that we were working on last time, which was all metal. And the first thing we're going to do, like we did on the other sides, we're going to be taking the top mount for the shock absorber there, and that's just going to go into the holes here. As you can see, there is a direction this goes. You know you've got it in the right ways because it should just slot in on its own, not be able to move. We're going to hold that in with some GM screws, and I've got them here. It's going to take three of them. Now, while I'm doing this video, you may hear sounds of a storm. I don't know if you can hear the wind there. Oh my God. It's pretty windy out here. Now, we've just had three storms in the UK. So it started off with Storm Dudley. Then we had a really bad Storm Eunice. And now I believe we've got Storm Franklin. So we are being battered in the UK at the moment. Now, I'm pleased to say, we battened down the hatches here and everything seems to be okay. Hopefully it will stay that way. The workshops are okay. No problems there at all. But there we go. That's the top mount in. We then got the shock absorber to put in. That's just going to go onto the underside of this. As you can see, it's a little keyhole shape. That's going to match what we've got on the shock here. So that's going to go in like this, held in from the other side with an MM screw. That's a flange screw that looks like that. Get this in. So that's got it nice and tight. And I'm using my heavy duty screwdriver to get these all the way in. The wearer screwdrivers are good. They pretty much work on every build, but it is good to have a screwdriver with a chunky handle like that, because obviously it gives you a lot more ability to tighten that up. But there we go. That's in place there. Now we're going to be putting this base over the top of this curved section here. That's going to go in like that. And on top of that, we have got a control box looking like that. So making sure we put this in the right way. It's going to go in like that. So obviously you can see all of this from that side there. And that's going to be held in from the underside with just one of these CP screws. So get that in, make that nice and tight. Excellent. And there you go. Now, a lot of people are modifying some of these things, especially what we did on the other side here, because things like the washer, reservoir, bottle, everything's black. And I'm sure there's going to be a lot more color underneath the engine there. But that's that in place. Now, in the control box, as you can see here, we've got two small holes. What we need to do is on the bottom hole, we've got this tiny nipple to attach that looks like that. That's going to go in the very bottom one. And I just want to make sure that's pushed all the way in, because we don't want to lose this at a later time. It's not going to need glue. And then the other one we've got, which is bent at a right angle here. Hard to show you, but looks like that. I have got a pipe, which I'm going to put on. And that's going to go just into the top one there. Now, this end has got a semicircular pattern on it, so it can only go in one way. So try not to force it and put it in the way it's meant to go. So I've got my glasses on here, magnifying glasses, to hopefully help me out with that. And when that's in, that should look just like that. So we're now going to mirror what we've done on the other side here, because we're going to be putting the wheel arch in place. But what we're going to do is I'm going to put a spring that we got here just over that shock absorber. We're going to make sure that that shock absorber, when we put this in, oh, that's just fallen off. I'll put that back on in a second. Just like we've done for the other side, mounting that onto the casing, making sure that's fitted in perfectly there. And then just like last time, we're going to be mounting that to this side of the car like that. Now this is going to be held in with some EM screws. So I've got them here. Let's put some free EM screws in here. One down the bottom, one here. Did I say free EM? I didn't mean free EM at all. I meant two EM screws. So that's in, no problems at all. So if I just turn this over like this, then we've got a couple more screws to put into place. Just on the top here, we've got an EM screw. That's just going to go into this hole here. And that will secure the back section down here. I am using my heavy duty screwdriver to help me with that. And then just into the side here, we've got a GM screw going in. Just like this. And then that's that arch fully in position. So I can turn that back around, and all I have to do then is just put the strut mount cover on that looks like that. That presses down at the top. And when that's done, that should look just like that. Stage 16, we're going to finish the other wheel off. So I'll get these out. And I am just going to start by just dropping this into some hot water that I've already got here. Now, unlike other tyres for cars, we don't really need to keep this in here that long. It's just to make it a little bit more pliable for us when we actually put these parts in. So we're going to put one side of the rim in here, make sure that goes all the way down. And then the other side is going to match it on the other side here, making sure we line up the lugs. So put that in like that. Revolve it round to there. And then we're just going to hold that together with some EM screws. And you will find, doing it this way, you're not fighting with it. It's just nice and easy to get everything in here. So make them nice and tight. We want the brake disc assembly that we had here. I believe this was from stage 9. And I'm going to be taking the disc, and that's just going to slip into there like that. And as you can see, these do have like a keyhole pattern. So try and match that pattern off so it goes all the way through. Bring over the chassis. And I'm going to fit this where it goes on this side. It's actually standing on its end there, so that it goes all the way down here. We're then going to be taking the tire here, and that's going to be going on top. Again, we've got that same keyhole pattern in there, so we want to match that off as well. And that's going to go in with an FM screw, but that screw is going to go into a little washer that we've got here. Make sure that's on nice and tight. So that looks like that. And then what we'd normally be doing is we're putting the hub just over the top of this and securing that in with AM screws all the way around. But I won't be doing that on mine because I am using Mike Lane's hub conversion kit. Now, I have got a video on the channel which shows me installing these, and I'll put that up here. I didn't know where it was then, just to show you what that looks like. So I'm going to put these all on now and show you the finished outcome. And there you go. When that's on, that looks like that. That one's with Mike Lane's mod. So as you can see, you can't see any screws in there. It matches the one on this side. And then I'm just going to attach the brake line that we've got on this side just to the nipple on this side here of the brake. This is a little bit long, so I'm going to cut that down a little bit and push this into place. Just like that. And that is all there is to do in that stage. You know what, I've been very naughty. Normally I show you all the magazines. So let me just show you issue 15. There were the instructions that we did in issue 15 here, looking like that. And the ones that we've just done, just in case you are working along with me or you didn't want to do the mod, you just want to follow as stock, that looks like that. As you see, we did the tire and then we put the actual wheel on and then we put the brake line in, as you can see there. So stage 17 looks like this. And I'm going to just quickly flick through the magazine now, because I'm very much aware that I haven't really showed you the magazine as well, but all about the Knight Rider series. And as you can see here, we're going to be creating what looks like the radiator and the cooling fans there. So we're going to be putting all of these together, and that's what we're doing in this stage. So I've got all that here, and this is the bracket that the fans are going to go onto, and they're actually going to go onto this side. So all we've got to do is grab these like this. As you can see, you've got an indent on one side here. That's just going to go over the top like that, and it's going to be held in with a DP screw. So I've got that here, one now. Three fans to do this too. Repeat that in the middle. That's the second. As you can see, they can still turn in there. And this one here is the third. Three fans in place. Now, as you can see on the tabs of the brackets here, we've got some little lugs. That's what we're going to be attaching this to. So I'm going to line that up with the holes in this. One, two, line up the bottom ones as well. It can only go on one way, so if it doesn't fit one way, just flip it like I've done there, and you can see that fits perfectly on there now. And then we're going to be putting that in with BP screws. Now every hole that we've got, 1, 2, 3, 4, it's going to take 4 BP screws. Now we are like 17 stages into this now, and it is apparent that you get plenty of screws for this. I think in every single stage you get one additional screw per pack. So keep them safe just in case you do lose one to the carpet monster. They're always handy to have. I've got a whole, look, I mean, look at this. This is my magnetic from all the builds I do. I've got hundreds in there. You never know when a screw can come in handy, especially if you've stripped the thread of one and you need something slightly bigger or something, and you haven't got a tap. But there you go, that's in place. That's quite detailed, isn't it? Look at that. And that's all there is to do in that stage. So in the last stage, stage 18 here, once again I'll just show you the magazines, because I very rarely tend to do that. I'll flick through the pages so you can see exactly what sort of content you get in this build, and each stage comes with one of these. And as you can see here, it looks like we've got some pipes and stuff to go, and we've got the mount for the radiator here, so we're going to fit that all together. So it looks like that, and we do actually get to mount this on the vehicle, which is good as well, but we are going to have to keep the pipes safe by the look of it. So assembling the radiator is the first thing to do. So we just need the two sides of the radiator looking like this, and they're just going to go together like that. Now these are slightly raised up, and the reason they are is because obviously we're going to be creating the part that we just had into there. That's going to go over the top like that there. Making sure that's all lined up correctly. And that's going to be held in with two BP screws. So I've got them here, one in this side. Excellent. One in the other side. Perfect. Then this completed unit here is going to go onto the mounting bracket. It's going to fit on like that, and it's going to be secured in from this side. As you can see, we've got four holes in here. It's going to be secured into this side just over those holes right there. Now it is directional, so if it doesn't fit one way, just flip it over so it goes the other way. So it's going to be going in like that, but we do have these braces to put in. So when we put them in, we're going to be having these cross-sectioned on each side here. It's going to be a little bit difficult. So I'll put this one in first with some CP screws and show you what I mean with that. It's going to be a little bit tricky to get these in. But here we go. The easiest way to get these in, I'm guessing, is to hold this in your screwdriver like that. Line up the holes. If your holes aren't lining up, you need to flip around the fan in the inside. It can only go in one way because of the shape of the radiator, and then get this in. So there we go, I've got the first one in there. and then just make that tighter. Yeah, just make sure that all the holes here line up. If they don't, you're going to need to flip this around here. Let's put the second one in. I haven't tightened this up at all. I'm tightening that up. So as you can see now, we've got the first brace across like that. I'm just going to repeat that for the other side. So when that's in, that should look just like that. And that's what it should look like from the other side there. Now, these should be on the right-hand side. We've got some pipes to put in there. We've got this one here. That's going to go onto the top tab, like that. And then we've got a longer one, which is just going to go onto the bottom tab, like that there. Now, we're going to mount this onto the chassis. And that's just going to go onto these two points just at the top here, like this. There. And it's going to be held into place with EM screws. I've got them here. So one this side. Make sure they're tight. And I'll give you a close up around there. That's what everything looks like that we've done today. Done a load, haven't we? But that's all there is to do in that pack. That wasn't too bad. I mean, I'd be surprised if you managed to get those pipes into the size of that control box without breaking the little tiny plastic nipples. I know a few of you have done that already because I've been reading the Facebook group, but nothing a little bit of glue can't help with her. But I make mistakes, so you don't have to. Just be extra careful when you're putting them in. Remember, that top one with the long pipe is shaped. But as you can see, look, mine's got in absolutely fine now, so we're all happy. If you want to get this for yourself, once again, I have put the link to the Fanhome website in the video description, but I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.